Our lead story tonight, the Prime Minister today addressed the nation a day after India crossed the 100 crore or 1 billion vaccine doses milestone. Prime Minister Modi thanked world leaders who had congratulated India and stressed that vaccinations in India were free of cost for every Indian. There was no VIP culture of entitlement and how it was a triumph of Indian science. The opposition, however, are questioning why it is that the Prime Minister hasn't mentioned the horrific second wave deaths just a few months ago and also why it's become like a BJP campaign.
A day after India touched a landmark 100 crore vaccine doses, the Prime Minister's address to the nation.
Krutam me dakshine haste. जयो में सव्य आहितः।
The government has gone into a celebration overdrive. 100 monuments all over the country lit up in the tricolor. Key architects of the vaccine plan giving out interviews. Even the Prime Minister writing editorial pieces in all major newspapers of the country. Prime Minister Modi claims the vaccine drive has answered all questions of critics.
क्या भारत इस वैश्विक महामारी से लड़ पाएगा? भारत दूसरे देशों से इतनी वैक्सीन खरीदने का पैसा कहां से लाएगा? भारत को वैक्सीन कब मिलेगी? भारत के लोगों को वैक्सीन मिलेगी भी या नहीं? क्या भारत इतने लोगों को टीका लगा पाएगा कि महामारी को फैलने से रोक सके? भांति भांति के सवाल थे, लेकिन आज ये 100 करोड़ वैक्सीन डोज हर सवाल का जवाब दे रहा है।
The Prime Minister said that since the disease does not discriminate between the rich and the poor, it was ensured that the VIP culture of entitlement does not dominate the campaign.
सबको साथ लेकर देश ने सबको वैक्सीन मुफ्त वैक्सीन का अभियान शुरू किया। अगर बीमारी भेदभाव नहीं करती तो वैक्सीन में भी भेदभाव नहीं हो सकता। इसलिए यह सुनिश्चित किया गया कि वैक्सीनेशन अभियान पर वीआईपी कल्चर हावी न हो।
बट अपार्ट फ्रॉम द सेलिब्रेशंस द चैलेंजेस रिमेन। India has only vaccinated about 20% of its population completely. A significant challenge also remains the dip in the first doses. Back in the political world, the Prime Minister's celebration over the vaccine has been greeted with skepticism by the opposition.
He delayed to acknowledge the existence of COVID in India. That was the costliest experiment made. With that, thousands of lives were lost. People suffer.
With experts in the government now saying that the next billion doses will be complete within the next 3 to 4 months, it will be interesting to see how the vaccine overdrive will play a role in the narrative building ahead of assembly elections. NNDTV Bureau Report.
Well, also, India's low cases and high vaccinations, a great combination at a time that cases are going up again, even in countries which are highly vaccinated. So in the United States, we're seeing again in the last 24 hours, cases are up. And in the United States, for instance, the cases up, as you can see, in the United Kingdom as well, cases 51,724. In Russia, it's facing its highest ever cases and deaths since the pandemic, over 35,000 cases and over 1,000 deaths. Turkey, Brazil all high. India is at the lowest in the top five at just over 15,000. Again, that's remarkable given a high population. Now, China is also facing a fresh outbreak. Currently, it's only of 43 cases. But remember, these figures are often highly suspect because China controls data so closely. Also, China is reacting strongly, cancelling flights, schools, colleges in many districts where the outbreak has been reported, all linked to one Chinese tourist couple. Well, the other big headline tonight, Home Minister Amit Shah will be visiting Kashmir and Jammu for the first time after 370 was abrogated. His visit comes at a time that there have been a rise in clashes between Indian security forces and Pakistan-backed terrorists. In fact, currently, a 12-day encounter is still on. It's one of the longest ever anti-terrorist encounters in Jammu and Kashmir, where 9 soldiers have died. This is on currently in the Poonch sector.
तमाम आजाद से गुजारिश किए जाते हैं कि वे अपने अपने बाल बच्चों को लेकर अपने अपने घरों में बंद हो जाए।
Heavy firing and loud explosions in the forests of Poonch in Jammu. Indian soldiers engaged in a heated encounter in one of the longest anti-terror operations in Jammu and Kashmir. Firing resumed after an over 36-hour long lull following weekday's announcement from mosques asking people to stay indoors. 9 soldiers, including 2 officers, have been killed in action.
It is one of the toughest anti-militancy operations in a region that was considered free from militancy since 2003. The resurgence of militants and the difficulty army is facing to flush them out has come at a time when Home Minister Amit Shah is visiting Jammu and Kashmir, his first visit after abrogation of J&K's special constitutional status.
In Srinagar's Lal Chowk area, drone surveillance on the eve of the Home Minister's visit. The CRPF said drone surveillance will be part of heightened security in areas where minorities, Kashmiri Pandits and Sikhs are living.
Minority ilake ko zyadatar hamare nazar pahunche aur unko jitna security de sakte hain wo dein. Yahan humne naka bhi laga rakhe hain aur sath sath jaise aap jante hain abhi physical testing aur checking chal raha hai. Umeed karta hu ki yahan koi incident na ho.
After recent targeted attacks on migrant workers and minorities, the state police have launched a massive crackdown in Kashmir. In the last 2 weeks, the police said 17 terrorists, including those responsible for the recent killings, have been gunned down. NDTV spoke to migrant workers at the construction site where they work and live. Mainly from UP, they say they're not leaving the valley. Wages here at rupees 600 a day are almost double what they get at home.
तो अच्छे से रहते हैं, अच्छे से जाते हैं, कोई डर नहीं है, सब जगह जाते हैं। काफी साल से मैं यहाँ पे हूँ, कम से कम 10 साल मुझे हो गए हैं। तो बाहर के लोग देखते हैं कि हाँ कुछ दिक्कत है, हम तो यहाँ पे रहते हैं, हमें तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं।
हाल में सर मेरे को आए हुए इधर 2 महीने हुए हैं, ये कभी कभी ऐसा माहौल इधर बन जाता है जी, इसलिए कोई दिक्कत वाली बात नहीं, रहना है जी, काम करके जाना है।
During his 3-day visit, the Home Minister is expected to review security and development, inaugurate 2 medical colleges and meet religious and political leaders. On Sunday, he will address a BJP rally in Jammu to showcase what the BJP says is public approval of the decision on abrogation of special status. With Nazir Masoodi, Usama Shah for NDTV.
We'll bring you the latest updates on that. But meanwhile, in other news, actor Ananya Pandey has told the Narcotics Control Bureau that she didn't supply any drugs to Aryan Khan, who's currently in jail. This apparently is based on WhatsApp chats found on Aryan Khan's phone. She was questioned today for the second day and she's been called again on Monday. However, the larger question is how these WhatsApp chats are being leaked by the agency and details of the questioning.
Ananya Pandey at the Narcotics Control Bureau for a second time in 2 days. She's been called again on Monday.
Monday ko bulaya gaya hai aur uske baad aage ki karwai. Main aapko investigation se related koi detail nahi bata paunga.
Sources told NDTV Ananya Pandey was asked questions on chats that appeared to indicate that she helped Aryan Khan procure weed. The information leaked by the agency suggested that the chats recovered from Aryan Khan's mobile phone reveal that in the year 2018-2019, Ananya Pandey helped supply drugs to Aryan thrice by providing him the numbers of drug dealers, sources said. Sources also said that Ananya denied the supply-related talks in the chat conversations and told the NCB officials that she has never consumed or supplied the drugs.
The entire NCB investigation is based on WhatsApp chats. No blood tests have been done to prove consumption and no recoveries have been made from Ananya Pandey, who's being questioned for over 3 days, or Aryan Khan, who remains in jail.
Meanwhile, NCP spokesperson and Maharashtra cabinet minister has alleged that he received a threat call at his office. Nawab Malik has alleged that the Narcotics Control Bureau's zonal director has been involved in the extortion, a charge that Vankhade has denied.
ये जो कह रहे हैं कि 10 तारीख को मैं दुबई गया ही नहीं, जो शब्द भी इस्तेमाल किया है एक्सटॉर्शन, काफी घटिया शब्द है, मैं उनको रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ कि कुछ भी कोई एविडेंस दे, किससे पैसा लिया, क्या लिया पैसा, जस्ट आप कैरेक्टर असैसिनेशन कर रहे हो, टारगेट कर रहे हो।
फॉर द एनसीबी टू बिल्ड अ क्रेडिबल केस, इट हैज टू हैव मोर देन व्हाट्सएप चैट्स एंड टेक दिस इन्वेस्टिगेशन फॉरवर्ड। which is why Ananya Pandey's questioning on Monday is important ahead of Aryan Khan's bail hearing in the Bombay High Court on Tuesday. In Mumbai, with Sunil Singh and camera person Ashok Mahadik, Saurabh Gupta, NDTV.
Good news from the Supreme Court for women army officers who have been fighting a battle with the Indian Army over permanent commission. The Supreme Court today said that 39 women officers must get permanent commission, and for the others who have appealed, that the army must give concrete reasons why it hasn't been granted to them.
39 women army officers who had gone to the Supreme Court in August after they were denied permanent commission in the army, in other words, a career beyond a maximum 14 years, have reason to celebrate. Their dream of serving in uniform for a full military career has come true, with the centre telling the court that 39 of the 71 women who had appealed can continue to serve. But the court made it clear that it wants more detail on why the government had rejected the other 25 women officers who have been denied permanent commission because of disciplinary issues. 7 women officers have been found medically unfit. Till now, women officers were admitted to the Indian Armed Forces only as short service commissioned officers. Short service commissioned officers have a maximum tenure of 14 years. They can apply to be permanent commissioned officers who can serve beyond 14 years, but the decision is taken on a case-by-case basis. Currently, there are less than 100 women officers with a permanent commission in the army in non-medical posts.
इवन वो 26 महिला अधिकारियों का जिनको अभी आर्मी यह स्टैंड ले रही है कि उनको परमानेंट कमीशन नहीं दिया जा सकता, इवन उनके भी केस में सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने एक बहुत ही ऐतिहासिक फैसला सुनाते हुए यह कहा है कि आर्मी एक एफिडेविट फाइल करके बताएगी कि अगर जो रीजन दिए गए हैं या ग्राउंड जो क्रिएट किए गए हैं उनको मना करने के लिए परमानेंट कमीशन के लिए।
बाकी महिला अधिकारी जो इतने लंबे टॉर्चर से गुजरी, जिसमें ना केवल उन्होंने अपने कलीग्स का क्रिटिसिज्म सहा, उसके अलावा समय लगा, जब वे 20 साल सर्विस कर ही चुकी हैं, अपनी योग्यता सिद्ध कर ही चुकी हैं, तो एक दायित्व की तरह भारतीय सेना को उन्हें परमानेंट कमीशन देकर एक स्थायी करियर दे देना चाहिए, जैसा कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने भी बार बार कहा है।
Today's order comes within weeks of the Supreme Court making it clear to the government that there should not be any delays in allowing women candidates the opportunity to join the National Defence Academy, till now an all-male bastion. This will enable women to get a permanent commission from the beginning of their careers, unlike women officers so far who had to join as short service commission officers.
The next hearing of the case will take place in the second week of November, when the government will have to come back to the top court with clear answers on why 25 women officers are still being denied permanent commission. In New Delhi with Rajiv Ranjan and Vishnu Shom, this is Sukirti Dwivedi for NDTV.
Well, moving across to what is really great news, and these are midday meal is back in Karnataka's government schools. This after the schools have opened after a gap of nearly 18 months, and today midday schools have begun again.
Hot food for hungry children in the middle of their school day. Even after the reopening of schools in Karnataka, the midday meal scheme was on hold until this week.
Tumba khushi aagta ide ma'am. ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಆದರೆ ಅಮ್ಮ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಬೇಗ ಎದ್ದು ಅಡುಗೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಿತ್ತು, ತುಂಬ ಲೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಗೆ ಬರೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಸ್ಕೂಲಲ್ಲೇ ಊಟ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅಮ್ಮಂಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಈಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೂ ವರ್ಕ್ ಸೋ ಶೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ವರ್ಕ್ ಅರ್ಲಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್
ಕೊರೋನಾ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಊಟ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಇವಾಗ ಬರ್ತೈತೆ, ತುಂಬ ಖುಷಿ ಆಗ್ತೈತೆ.
ಅಕ್ಷಯ ಪಾತ್ರ ಇಸ್ ನೌ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ 75,000 ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಇನ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು with a midday meal, with funding from the state government and private donors.
Government has done a commendable job in alleviating the hunger in this country. Akshay Patra is also striving its best to serve children hot, nutritious and tasty meals.
And the promise of full tummies for school children is already seeing an improvement in attendance.
I expect by Monday all the students will come. 10% attendance will be there. Without tiffin they were coming. Again afternoon they were feeling very tired.
The COVID-19 pandemic had a huge impact on many aspects of our lives. And for children, it meant the loss of a hot midday meal, even after schools opened once again. But now after 18 months, hot meals are being served at lunchtime in schools here in Karnataka. And for these children, it's a very, very welcome move indeed. With DM Kumar, Maya Sharma in Bengaluru for NDTV.
It's stories like these and really the midday meal scheme, which should really be top of our agenda. But here's what's happening in one of India's biggest high-tech cities, Gurugram, home to multinationals. But now you're seeing the worst kind of low-level hate, where namaz is being disrupted with people shouting Jai Shri Ram slogans, even though they are at designated sites. Meher joins me now from this site, because Meher, this has really now become a big focus and a source of tension in, as I said, one of India's millennial cities, one of India's smart cities. Why has this become such a communal low-level hate flashpoint?
Yes, Sonia. So we're at the Sector 12 in Gurugram, where this afternoon people who were peacefully offering namaz were protested against, if we can say that. There were slogans of Jai Shri Ram, and the police was actually present. The police was actually present, but they didn't stop. The people actually got very close to people who were offering namaz. We'll try to speak to some of the people who were here at the time, who've confirmed to us that this is a designated site confirmed with the government that they are allowed to offer namaz here, but still there are elements of society here who are against this. So sir, aapse thodi baat karna chahenge, aapka naam bata dijiye.
Main chairman Haji Shahzad Khan Gurugram.
So sir, aap hame bata rahe the ki yahan namaz padhna allowed hai, aapne government se baat kar rakhi hai aur puri permission hai yahan namaz padhne.
Dekhiye, yahan par 2018 mein jo jagah chinhit hui thi, 6 महीने बाद ये वहाँ किसी जगह पर विवाद होने से 2019 में ये जगह लिस्ट में आ गई थी प्रशासन के और हमारे सब लोगों के बीच में सहमति बनी थी. सेक्टर 12 रेड लाइट पर इस्लाम कबाड़ी के सामने ये नगर निगम की लैंड है और तब से ही हम यहाँ पर नमाज पढ़ रहे हैं. किसी को किसी तरह की कोई आपत्ति नहीं है, लेकिन अभी कुछ लोग पिछले शुक्रवार भी आए थे, इस शुक्रवार भी आए थे, बजरंग दल के कुछ विश्व हिंदू परिषद के लोग आए थे और आज उन्होंने तो हमारे सर पे आके जय श्री राम के नारे लगाए, जबकि हालांकि प्रशासन बहुत था, हमारे सर पे नहीं आना चाहिए था. कहीं ना कहीं हमें ऐसा लगा कि पुलिस का जो कार्यशैली रही वो फेलियर रही है, जो हमारे सर पे उन्होंने आके श्री राम के नारे लगाए हैं.
Right, and here, interestingly, the person leading it, and it's often just attempts at cheap publicity, trying to become famous, was apparently the man who was involved in defending the person who also fired bullets recently as well. So it's really become about a publicity campaign and gimmick there. Why aren't the police acting? What are the police saying?
Exactly. The police right now has not said much to us. They were present here and a witness to everything that's happened. But the fact that these incidents have happened multiple times, it's been over a month that such protests have been conducted by right-wing Hindu groups, and the police hasn't done much. They said yes. Today they said that they made some concessions. What those concessions were to calm the situation here is not clear, since this is a designated site for namaz. So the police's stance on this has been very concerning.